Hey everybody, Delilah here with another episode of My Writing Journey. I know you're probably wondering, what's that on her face? Well, it's just the sticker I voted. I like to wear my voting stickers in strange places. Just ignore that. Today we're going to be staying in the adolescent age of my writing. It's a couple of years past last episode's work, and you can tell a little bit in the maturity of what I'm writing and how I'm writing, hopefully, anyway. Though it's a little bit of a step back because you'll see that this is when I was doing my prime fanfiction work. And boy, oh boy, is this going to be interesting. How this is going to work, as usual, is I'm going to answer 5 questions about my life and what had been going on in that time that kind of influenced the way that I wrote, and then I'm going to read you a little bit of an excerpt from work at that time, and then I am going to answer 2 final questions relating to the work itself. The first question is, how old was I at this point? The very first page of this little project, I guess, is 4/21/07. So I was 17 when I started this work. Question number 2 is, what were some important themes in my life? Well, at 17, I do recall there were a lot of things going on in my life. I guess a kind of theme of not being prepared and feeling like I'm not prepared. So I was getting ready for college and I felt kind of ill-prepared for it for whatever reason. I was getting my driver's license, felt very unprepared for that. I had my first boyfriend at that point, and I felt a lot of pressure to do things that I definitely wasn't prepared for. And yeah, at 17 there was just a lot of, I'm not ready for this. Where am I going? What am I gonna do? I was struggling with moving forward and not being ready to, at least in my head. And I think my writing fanfiction kind of reflected that. I guess fanfiction was kind of a way for me to draw back into myself and use what I was comfortable with to express myself, use the work of other people pretty much to be comfortable in my own skin. And I know that sounds really, really weird, but if you've ever written fanfiction, I'm pretty sure you might understand where I'm coming from with this. Question number 3 is, were there any specific highlights or obstacles I was dealing with at the time? So some highlights of that point, well, I had my first boyfriend. I thought that was really cool. And my grades were doing really well. I was getting a lot of awards. I was in a scholarship program. I was really putting myself out there when it came to academics. So that was a great highlight. And family life was great. I believe my sister had moved on to college at that point, so I was kind of the only child in the house, so I got a lot of attention and just a lot of interesting things going on. Question number 4, what did I think about writing? I was starting to think, hey, I can be a writer. I want to be a writer. You know, I didn't necessarily think that was going to be my way of making a living, but I definitely thought about it in terms of, you know, this is something I can do forever and I'm going to have a lot of fun doing it. And so I started to take my writing a lot more seriously. I started to care about what other people thought of my writing. And finally, question number 5 is, what did I want to be when I grew up? I knew for sure at that point I wanted to be an elementary school teacher. I wanted to be an elementary school teacher and write books on the side. This was when that whole teaching writing thing was really at the forefront of my mind. There are a lot of things I still wanted to do. I wanted to be a wife, I wanted to be a mother, even a stay-at-home mom, but I really wanted to teach, and I really wanted to teach like elementary school. That would change later on, of course, but yeah, that was where my focus was. So now comes the time when I'm going to be reading you an excerpt from my work, and I have to add a little note on here because this is kind of a special area when it comes to my writing. As a teenager, I wrote a lot of fan fiction, and as an adult, I don't necessarily feel like it was my proudest moment of writing. A lot of my creativity came from that time, but at the same time, I was writing using other people's work And I personally did take stories and write them in AU fashion, which would be alternate universe, but at the same time, those characters did not belong to me. And sitting here in front of you now, I don't feel like it would be a good idea on my conscience to read with the actual characters' names, just out of respect for the original owner of that work. So, because it's an AU story, I think it's okay to go ahead and read the actual script of what I wrote, but I'm not going to be saying the character's name out of respect. If you, you might be able to figure out what kind of fanfiction I'm writing for if you're a fan of anime or whatever, but I'm just going to try and be respectful to the original content owner, and I'm going to change the names. I'm not making money off of this, I'm just reading it to you. I'm going to change the names, or if I get caught up, I'll just kind of mute it and replace it with another word, just out of respect. And I'm going to be reading from a story that I titled The Picture on the Wall, and this first chapter is called Enough. I'm just reading a couple of pages from it. Enough, her mind screamed. She wasn't going to keep going back and forth between past and present. This was the now. Finally, she opened the door and peeked her head in the room. She said sternly, I came here to... There was no one in the room. She took a step inside. She observed that his computer desk was littered with unsigned, seemingly unlooked at papers. It was as if he had picked up and left. The telephone had a blinking red light on it. He was missing phone calls? She couldn't stop herself from pushing the button. You have 94 messages. 94 messages? Something wasn't adding up here. Where did he disappear to? She started going through all of his papers and notebooks, checking for any clue as to where her husband could be. Nothing. He just up and left. Left her. Agitated, she plopped into the office chair and gave a huff. What to do now? She looked over at the picture scroll decorating the office wall. It was a colorful portrait of a woman from feudal Japan. She was a beautiful woman, whoever she was, with deep midnight hair that ran past her shoulders and out of the portrait's range and matching, haunting eyes. She had only seen the portrait one other time, and that was when he brought it home. She hadn't really thought about it otherwise. But now that she had a chance to get up close, she realized the true beauty of the portrait. The eyes were so haunting and hypnotizing that she stepped closer to get a better look. It's almost like an ancient Mona Lisa, she commented. I feel like she's trying to tell me something. It's here. I can feel it. She looked around her, wondering where the faint whisper had come from. I must take it before it gets away. Startled, she was about to make a bolt for the door when the phone started to ring once again, scaring the living daylights out of her. Oh, typo. Completed distracted from the wall scroll, she started inching toward the ringing phone. In the process, she did not see the wall scroll flip mysteriously to its other side by itself. She missed the new image that now decorated the wall. Most importantly, she missed the pair of gnarled claws coming out of the scroll reaching toward her. It's mine now. I can feel the power. Startled once again, she turned to look for the voice, but it was too late. The claws clutched painfully around her shoulders, causing her to scream out. The hands drew her back at an alarming speed, and suddenly, everything went black. All she could do was hold on and scream. And fall. That was a little long. So now that I read that excerpt, sorry it was a little bit long, I just wanted to get a little bit more of the story in there so it didn't just seem like random actions. I'm gonna answer these two final questions about the writing. Question number 6. What did I like about my writing then? I have to repeat what I've said many times about my imagination. Even though this is fan fiction, I really put a lot of work into thinking about different scenarios and alternate universes that these characters could be in, and I'm really proud of myself for having that. the description was really good, especially when describing the picture scroll. I mean, it wasn't the best. I wasn't like top-notch describing things, but I think that the description was very interesting. And it really gave a tone to the writing. And I don't know if the other writings I've read so far, I don't remember, but they didn't really have tone like this does. The previous one with the adventure story, it had tone, but it was just kind of like all over the place and mood. And this one, it ends on a really nice cliffhanger. You know, she's pulled by gnarled claws, and she's screaming and falling, and we don't know what's happening to her. And I thought that was really exciting. It's a shame I never got past that point. Final question is, what improvements could I have made then? I think there are a lot of technical issues with the writing. I mentioned that there was a typo, completed, distracted. That's, you know, that happens to me even now. That happens to most writers. It's just distracted writing, really. So I'm not really too concerned about that. What does bother me a little bit is, it's kind of a repeat of when I was little and I used to just kind of go, and then she did this. And then she did this, and then this happened, and then this happened, and then she did this. And it could use a little bit more of a break, you know? Talk about, she did this, and then she felt like this. She did this, and then she noticed these things around her. That could have broken that up a little bit and given it a little more life, and not made it feel so... like continuous motion. Break it up a little bit with description. I think I could have benefited from that. And before you say that there was too much pronoun use, remember that I took out the characters' names out of respect for the author, the original author. So a lot of the she's, and she did this, and she did this, and she poked her head in the door, that was just me replacing the character name. So don't worry. Though I did notice there was a bit more pronoun usage than I thought. So just word variation. And that I actually remember once I got to college, that was something I got called on a bit. Yeah, I guess things I could have worked on was breaking things up, breaking up continuous action with some description, you know, having a nice balance, word variation, and working on some of the more technical aspects, of course. I think there was a sentence that bothered me at the very beginning. This was the now. That's what it was. This was the now. It's wrong. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that excerpt and that analysis of what was going on in my life. If we're still in high school, I think there might be one more instance of me being in high school to go through. But if not, then the next episode will be talking about my early college year writing. So that's going to be really exciting. A quick note to all of you who are participating in NaNoWriMo. I'm so proud of you. I'm so happy for you. And I am cheering for you. You keep going. And that's going to be awesome. Can't wait to hear about your experiences. Other than that, I know I'm talking really, really fast, but other than that, I don't really have anything else for you today. I hope that you're having an awesome day, and I'll see you next week in my next video. Bye!